Okay, who's finished? All right, I would like some examples, please. Read what you wrote.
Yes.
I can't do this, and I'm going to lose.
Cool.
Yes. Why am I here?
Uh-huh. I'm tired, I'm going to die.
I'm tired, I'm going to die. I don't want to disappoint my team. I don't want to disappoint my coaches. Yeah? I hate this event.
I'm afraid to go slow.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't swam fast.
Oh, that's a good one. Haven't swam fast all season. Yeah? What else? Yes?
Uh-oh, is there ever been easy moments?
Okay.
I plan to go a certain
He's enormous, and I got to get certain times. Now, I have a dumb thing for you to consider. This is really stupid. Imagine hearing those negative thoughts that you say to yourself. You're right before the race. You're on the blocks. You're behind the blocks. Imagine hearing those negative thoughts in Russian. I'm assuming none of you speak Russian. And if you speak Russian, then put them in a different language, Spanish, French. What would you hear? If you had negative thoughts going on in your head, but we could figure out a way to get the thoughts to go into Russian, what would you actually hear?
You wouldn't understand it.
You would not, you'd hear gibberish. You wouldn't understand a word. So what I'm suggesting to you is when you have negative thoughts going on, you want to just sort of hear them and refocus. You don't want to jump into them. You don't want to get involved. Does anybody know what it means to get emotionally hijacked? What does it mean to get emotionally hijacked? Yes?
You let your emotions get the best of you.
Okay, do you notice right now, as we're going through this, that there's a set number of people that are answering my questions? Do you notice that there is a number of people that aren't answering my questions? Whose training session is this? Is it mine? No. I would like you to take some responsibility to get outside your comfort zone and to get something out of this talk. And you can't get anything out of the talk unless you put yourself into it. Now here's the thing. You may wish you were somewhere else this morning. But where are you? See, you're here. And if you would like this morning to last forever, then my suggestion to you is think about how this is taking so long and you wish you were somewhere else. Because if you do that, and if you watch the clock and time me, I can promise you, we will be here for the next 3 years. That's how it will feel. So I want you to get out of your comfort zone. I want you to make this important to you. And if it's not important to you, that's cool, but, you know, it's going to be a long morning. So what did I just ask? I lost track. Refocus. What did I just I just asked something. Yes. Yes. What else does it mean? Someone gave a good definition. What else does emotionally hijack? Let your emotions run away with you, right? Who said that? Somebody said that. Yes. What else? Oh, but I can't raise my hand and speak up because I don't usually talk to people. So I'm not comfortable. Yes.
Letting yourself get caught up with like what ifs.
Letting yourself get caught up with the what ifs. You know what happens to you when you get emotionally hijacked? You're toast. You understand what I mean by that? You get emotionally hijacked, you're gone. You lose your skills, you lose your training. And you can only get emotionally hijacked if you listen to that negative thinking. Your job when you hear negative thinking, here it is, right here. Here's the negative thinking. Your job is, it's nice to see you. Why don't you go get yourself a soft drink? Right now I have a race to do. And you want to refocus. You don't want to take your negative thinking seriously. You understand? You don't want to engage it. What do I mean by engaging your negative thoughts? Yes?
Don't allow yourself to believe them.
Don't allow yourself to believe them. What else does it mean to engage them?
Turn them off.
Louder?
Turn them off.
Turn, I'm sorry.
Turn them off.
Oh, can you turn negative thinking off? Yes or no? You can't turn negative thoughts off. Don't waste your energy. Don't waste your energy. Last minute negative thinking, doesn't have to affect you. Just refocus. Yes?
You don't want to encourage them,
right. Jumping in, you know, engaging them means you go from one thought to the next, and before you know, you're in a deep hole. Okay. Now, I want some honest feedback. Can you actually use what I'm talking about? I want to get some sense of where you're at. What can you take away from what I'm saying and use? As a matter of fact, from all the stuff we've been talking about, from confidence, the stuff we talked about this morning, I want to know if I'm presenting it in a way that's usable. I might not be. That's you know, a possibility. Yes?
Can you say, like, negative thinking and stuff is bad, but sometimes I use, like, the negative stuff to go faster.
Good. And does it work?
Sometimes.
Well, when it works, keep doing it. I just want you to understand, most people get freaked out by negative thoughts. I just want you to understand, it doesn't have to affect you, as long as you don't engage it. As long as you don't get involved in a conversation with the negative thinking. A lot of people fight it. You got a negative thought over here, and you start talking to it and trying to be positive. Because you're here from other people that you want to be positive. You don't want to be positive at the last minute. You just don't want to focus on it. At the last minute, because negative thoughts are in what column? What column? The left. Okay, so you just want to hear the negative thoughts, change your focus. Even to this day, as a tennis player, I constantly have to deal with negative thinking. I hear it, I don't respond to it. I go, oh, so there's my friend again, and I just move over and refocus on the next point. That's what you want to do before your races and during your races.